Before the advent of hip-hop, which has presently taken over the whole of Nigeria, Afrobeat, Juju and Highlife were widely celebrated throughout Nigeria from the early 1950s until late 1990s. The origin of these styles of music was largely attributed to Ghana, which was later spread to Sierra Leone, Liberia, Gambia and Nigeria through Ghanaian workers, among other West African countries by the 1930s. The music is often performed live with groups of singers and musicians in a band. In recent times, hip-hop music appears to be holding sway with the electronic media in Nigeria with massive airplay. Nonetheless, Fela Kuti, Ebenezer Obey and Sonny Ade's musical achievements have continued to inspire a vast generation of African musicians and music lovers who believe in the big band music setup. Hey guys, welcome to Songtown, the home of Juju music. In this video, I'll be showing you the top 10 Nigerian big band musicians of all time. Make sure you like this video and drop a comment about it. Number 10 on this list is the popular masked man, Lagbaja. Bisade Ologunde, popularly known as Lagbaja, was born in the Nigerian city of Lagos in 1960. He is a percussionist, vocalist, composer, and an Afrobeat artist. Lagbaja is well known for wearing a mask that conceals his identity. He rose to prominence with the release of his critically acclaimed debut album, Lagbaja, in 1993, which got a lot of airplay. He then went on to release Ikira, and in 1996, he released Se On African Thing. After teaching himself to play the saxophone, he established his first band in Lagos in 1991. His groovy fusion was dubbed Afro Jazz, Afrobeat, Highlife, and Afropop until he coined the word Africano, referring to the primary role of African rhythms and grooves in his music. His usage of the traditional African drums is a common thread running through all of his songs. In his music, traditional Yoruba drums are the most prominent percussion instruments. The Yoruba Talking Drum Ensemble in his music employs four families to create various rhythms and moods. Side by side, Simple Yes or No, Nothing for You, Afrikalypso, and Konko Below are just a few of his well-known songs. Lagbaja still remains active as he keeps performing live in various parts of the world. Shina Peters was born on May 30, 1958 in Ogun State, Western Nigeria. Sir Shina Peters, as he was commonly known, is an Afro-Juju musician whose style of play is described as a rhythmic collaboration of Afrobeat, Fuji and Juju with the use of guitars and other local instruments which pierced ethnic, cultural and language barriers in Nigeria. He was said to have changed and revolutionized the Juju music scene in Nigeria with his band called the International Stars that was formed in the late 1980s. He has over 16 albums which have led him to tour the shores of South Africa, Europe, Germany, United Kingdom, Italy and United States. Some of his most popular albums are Ace, Shinomania, Dancing Time, Experience and Payback Time. Oliver Sunday Akanite was born on April 14, 1947 in Anambra State in Eastern Nigeria. He started playing music at the age of 11 and was taught to play the guitar by a Congolese guitarist that was living in Nigeria. The cook was an apprentice of Juju musicians Sonny Agaga and Jacob Oluwale and became locally well known by the time he was a teenager. He received international attention after performing in London in 1973 and his guitar work was featured in Prince Nico Maga's 1977 album Sweet Mother. Many of his songs were noted to be in the Ogene genre, which is an Igbo traditional style of music. He loves to blend modern music with traditional Igbo harmonies. His singles include People's Club of Nigeria, Nembe Social Club, One Way, and Identity, the latter which spent several weeks on Radio Nigeria's Top 10 in 1981. In addition to his solo work, the cook frequently played with the Igede International Band led by his brother Eugene. Oliver passed away on June 21, 2008, at the age of 61. Number 7 on this list is Sir Victor Owifo. Sir Victor Owifo was born in Benin City, Edo State, Nigeria in 1941. He is not just a musician but also a writer, sculptor and musical instrument inventor. He is famous for his Ekasa music. Early in his career, Victor Owifo was a member of Bobby Benson's Highlife band. As a solo artist, Wifo made history in Nigeria when he was awarded the first golden record that was presented by Philips West Africa for his song Joromi in 1966. Joromi has legendary status among his fans, and his performances are characterized by his ability to play the guitar with both his feet and also his tongue. In 1995, Wifo was invited by the United Nations Staff Day International Committee to perform during the UN Golden Jubilee celebration. He is cited in the 1983 edition of the Groove Dictionary of Music and Musicians. He was also documented in the Who is Who in Nigeria, Who is Who in Africa, Who is Who in the Commonwealth, and Men and Women of Distinction in the Commonwealth sections. Victor Laya was born on the last day of the year in 1930 in Calabar, Cross River State, located in southern Nigeria. His Yoruba parents hailed from Ekiti State, southwestern Nigeria. He was regarded as one of the pioneers of highlife music in Nigeria and was even referred to as the evil genius of highlife. He has collaborated with other highlife musicians outside Nigeria. Some of them include Iti Mensah of Ghana. Victor Laya was a talented trumpeter as well as a band leader. He was highly educated and formed his own band called the Cool Cats in 1954 and renamed the group to All Stars Band in 1966, which once had and trained some popular music icons like the famous drummer Tony Allen and vocalist Fela Kuti in his group. Some of his popular albums include Odale Ore, Olaya's Victories, High Life Reincarnation, and many more. He passed away on February 12, 2000 in Lagos. Isaiah Kendi Dairo was born in 1930 in Ofa, Kwara State in western Nigeria. Dairo rose to fame shortly after he formed his band called the Morning Star Orchestra in 1957. His band made use of unique musical instruments like the akuba, ogido, maracas, agogo, the Yoruba samba, which was a square-shaped drum, and an amplified accordion that was played by Dairo, making him the first high-profile musician to play the accordion. Ike Dairo was the first truly international star of African music. His juju music was a lively mixture of traditional Yoruba social dance drumming, songs, and praise poetry, Latin America rhythms, and Christian hymns performed on the guitar, percussion, and talking drums. In a career that lasted several decades, Dairo made hundreds of records and toured Africa, Asia, Europe, and the Americas, paving the way for younger musicians like Sonny Ade, Ebenezer Obey, Shino Peters, and many others. His popular songs include Motiege, Yoruba Solidarity, Erora Fesojaye, Salome, and many others. Ike Dairo passed away in the year 1996. Once again, like this video and share, and let us know what you think about Nigerian musicians in the comment section. Fourth on the list is Osita Osadebe. Chief Stephen Osita Osadebe was born in March 1936 in Atani, Anambra State, located in southeastern Nigeria. Chief Osadebe, as he was popularly called because he is a titled high chief in Igbo land, is a singer-songwriter and a record producer, and was also known as the father of Igbo highlife music. His music was influenced by his personal life experience, trials, and tribulations. Chief Osadebe released his first album in 1958 and later established his record label that was named Polygram Records Nigeria. He went on to write over 500 songs, half of which were released commercially. Notable among his music is Kedu America. On the 11th of May 2007, Chief Osadebe passed away in the United States. Now we enter the final top 3. Third on the list is Commander Ebenezer Obey. Ebenezer Obefabi was born on April 3, 1942 in Ogun State, located in the western part of Nigeria. He is among the pioneers of modern juju music in Nigeria and was popularly known as the Chief Commander. Ebenezer Obey formed his own band called the International Brothers in 1964. He began experimenting with Yoruba percussion styles and expanding on the band by adding more drum kits, guitars, and talking drums. Obey's musical strengths lie in weaving intricate Yoruba axioms into dance floor compositions. As it is known of Nigerian Yoruba social circle music, the Inter-Reformers Band, which was the name Obey later gave his band, excelled in praise singing for rich Nigerian socialites and business tycoons. However, Obey somehow got converted and switched to full gospel music in the 1980s. He has over 100 of albums. His popular songs include Ewa Wonjuri, Board Members, The Man, The Horse and His Son, Good News, and so on. Before going through the remaining names on the list, here are some honorable mentions. Segun Adewale, Cardinal Rex Lawson, Nico Imbaga, Dr. Olandowo, and Fatai Rolling Dollars. Number 2 on this list is Fela Anikulapo Kuti. With his original name as Olufela Ransom Kuti, he became known widely as Fela. He was born on the 15th of October 1938 in Abeokuta, Ogun State, Western Nigeria. He was born into a well-connected Yoruba family, as his father was a Protestant minister and a school principal, and his mother was a feminist activist in the anti-colonial movement. He's also the first cousin to Wole Soyinka and the first African to win the Nobel Prize for Literature. Fela played for some time in Victor Laya's band, after which he formed his own music group called Africa 70. With his well-connected background, there is no doubt Fela became more famous and popular with his style of music, as he was the pioneer of the Afrobeat music. He was also a human rights activist, and he used his music to publicly criticize the corrupt military government of his time. He also used it to fight European cultural imperialism, as he supported traditional African religions and lifestyles. He has a lot of hits from various albums. Some of them are Shakara, Confusion, Zombie, and many more. In addition to these albums, he has a lot of live recordings. Some of them are Egypt 80, Teacher Don't Teach Me Nonsense, and so on. He has 3 Grammy nominations to his name. If you have made it this far, thank you for watching this video and please remember to share this video. Number 1 on the list is King Sunny Ade. Sunday Adeni was born on 22nd September 1946. His family is from Ondo State, southwestern Nigeria. He was born into a royal Yoruba family. His father was a church organist and his mother was a market trader. Sunday Ade is well known as one of the most influential juju musicians, as he was also a songwriter and multi-instrumentalist. Earlier in his career, he formed the group called The Green Spot, which he later changed the name to African Beat, whose music was characterized by the use of Yoruba talking drum, electric guitars, and synthesizers. With his juju music, King Sunny Ade became the first African to be nominated twice for a Grammy. Notable among his music albums are Odu and Synchro System. In 2009, King Sunny Ade was inducted into the Afro Hall of Fame at the Brooklyn African Festival in the United States, and he humbly dedicated the award to the late Michael Jackson. He has also featured in 2 Hollywood movies. Currently, King Sunny Ade runs his non-profit organization called the King Sunny Ade Foundation, and he is also working with the Music Copyright Society of Nigeria.